Please click on subscribe button and click on bell icon for more interesting updates on civil engineering concepts. In this video lecture, I will explain you pushover analysis of G+1 building by using ATAP software. So I was already done my modeling process, analysis process by using static analysis for the respected G+1 building. Now I will show you that respected G+1 building model. So click on this ATAP software. So this is my G+1 building model. So I was already done my static analysis for this respected building under the action of dead loading condition, live loading condition, seismic loading condition, as well as wind loading condition. So initially I will show you the material properties and dimensions of the frame sections for this respected building. So click on define option, material properties. So for this respected section, I was considered M30 grade concrete as well as Fe500 grade steel. So click on cancel. So again, click on define option. Let us consider section properties, frame sections. So for this respected building, I was considered the beam size, which is comes under the thickness of 230 cross 300 mm. Again, I was considered the column size, which is consisting of the dimensions of 300 cross 300 mm. So click on cancel again. So click on cancel option. So again, select the define option, select the section properties which is related to the slab section. So I was considered the slab section will be consisting of 120 mm for this respected building. So now I will explain you how to do the pushover analysis for this respected building. So before going to the pushover analysis, initially we need to unlock this respected model. So click on this unlock model. So click on OK option. So after that, we have to define the load cases, which is comes under the pushover load cases, which is in X direction condition and Y direction condition. So for that, initially we have to click on define option. So go to select to load patterns option. So initially I'm selecting the load case name as push X, let us consider here. So let us take it as push X and select the loading type which is related to the other type. Click on add option. Again, in the same process, we had to add the pushover load case in Y direction condition. Click on add option, close option. So after adding this respected pushover load cases, we need to add the cases. So go to define option. So select the load cases here, select here. Initially, we need to select this respected push X direction, which is comes under the linear static case. So again, click on modify load case option here. So here it will be consisting of name as push X, and we need to change the load case type from linear static to non-linear static. Why? Because basically we will consider the pushover load cases comes under your non-linear static only. So that's why just I'm taking it as non-linear static. Now we have to select the mass source function. Basically mass source function will be comes under MSSRC1. So if you are interested to define the mass source, initially you need to define the mass source and then you can add the mass source as per your considerations here. So again, here we have to select the initialization condition is zero initialization condition. So why? Because we are starting from the zero value. So here I'm selecting the load applied case, which is related to the acceleration UX with factor 1. Click on add option. So after that, we have to delete this respected dead load case condition. So click on this respected other parameters here. So here it will be consisting of load application, result saved, non-linear parameters. So we will change the modify the load application and result saved option as per the considerations. So initially I'm selecting load application option here. So it will be comes under your respected notation as full loading condition, displacement control. So here as per the consideration, we will take it as displacement control only. Okay, why? Because we have to control the displacement under the some conditions of load cases. So here I'm selecting here and control displacement, which is at a intensity magnitude of 240 mm. Click on OK. Again, we have to select the result saved, modify show. So here it will be consisting of final state only, multiple states only. So here I'm selecting it as multiple states. Click on OK. Again, we have to click on OK. In the same process, we have to select the linear static case. Click on modify show load cases. Again, in the same process, we have to select here as non-linear static. Now we have to select the mass source as MSSRC1. So here we have to select the acceleration in Y direction condition UY. Click on add option. So again, you have to select the other parameters here, like load application, modify here, displacement control. Again, you have to click on OK. So now we have to click on the result saved option here. Click on modify show. So it will be consisting of again final state and multiple states. So here I'm taking it as multiple states option. Click on OK. So after that, we have to click on OK option. So now I was taken the load cases here like this, which is comes under the pushover X direction, pushover Y direction under non-linear static. So before going to the pushover analysis case, we need to change the dead loading condition as well as your respected live loading condition type to non-linear static only. Okay. So for that, we have to select the non-linear static, modify here, and you have to change the load case from dead to non-linear static. So click on OK option. Again, in the same process, you have to select the live loading condition, modify here. So here again live loading condition also we have to change from non-linear state. Click on OK. So again you have to click on OK. So after defining the pushover X direction, pushover Y direction load cases, so we have to define the hinge properties. So basically this is one of the important step in pushover analysis. So if you skip this respective step, the results will not be shown for this respected pushover analysis case. So that's why this is important one. So initially we need to apply the hinge properties for the beam sections as well as column section. Okay, so initially I'm selecting here, go to select option, select here, properties here, select frame sections, just I'm taking it as beam, click on select, close. So after that we have to apply the hinges for this respected beam section. Go to assign option here. So in this we need to select the frames. So in this we need to select the hinges here. Okay, so we need to apply the hinges for the beams initially. So here I'm adding the relative distance will be at a distance of 0.05. so why? Because we need to add the hinge from the 0.05 from the one end and 0.95 from the another end. Okay, for the frame sections. So initially we need to click on this respective relative distance, click on add option. So here we have to select the table as per the AC4113. So here I'm selecting it as concrete beam members. Why? Because we need to apply the hinges for the concrete members. So here I'm selecting the degree of freedom will be comes under M3 section. So now we have to select the V value, which is nothing but the shear value for the pushover X direction condition. Select here as push X. So again we have to click on OK option. Again in the same process we have to add the relative distance as 0.95. so click on add. Again in the same process we have to select the pushover X direction for the beam section. So click on add. So in the same process we have to add the hinge properties for the pushover Y load cases. So here I'm selecting load case name as push Y. So same table as well as your respected hinge property table. So again in the same process just I'm taking it as 0.95. click on add under the action of the pushover load case Y direction condition. Click on OK option. Again you have to click on OK. Okay, so now you can see the hinge properties are applied for this 3D structure. Now I will show you this respected 3D structure by using elevation view. Click on elevation view, let us consider A option, click on apply, click on OK. Now we can see the hinge properties are applied for this respected beam section under the distance of 0.05 from this respected node point. Okay, so it is considered here as 0.05 node point, and this respected remaining distance will be comes under the distance of 0.95 for this frame. So in the same process we have to add the hinges for the column section. So for that go to select option, select here, property here. So in the same process we have to select frame sections which is related to the columns. Click on select, click on close. Go to assign option, frame section. Now we have to select the hinges here. So initially we need to add the relative distance will be of 0.05. click on add option. So now here we have to select the table as per the same. So here we have to change to concrete column and section. So here we have to change the degree of freedom from M3 section to M2 M3 section. P is the lateral load, M2 is the moment in X direction, M3 is the moment in Z direction. So now we have to select the pushover X direction load case. Click on OK. Again in the same process we have to add the pushover load which is at a distance of 95 with X direction pushover condition with a PM2M3. Click on add. Again in the same process we have to add 0.05. click on add. In the same process we have to change the load from pushover X to pushover Y. Now we have to change the relative distance to 0.95. so click on add. Here we have to change the pushover Y condition with PM2M3. click on OK. So now we can see all the relative distance and hinge properties are defined here. So initially we need to click on OK option. So now we can see the hinge properties are assigned here for this respective structure of G+1 building for the column sections also. Now click on apply, click on OK. Now you can see these are the hinge properties which is having at a distance of relative distance of 0.05 from this respective node point in up direction condition. Again it is having the hinge property results for this respective section under the considerations of 0.95 distance for the bottom section here. Okay, so after that we have to click on the 3D view. So after assigning the hinge properties we need to analyze this respective structure. So for that go to analyze option. So initially we need to select the check models option. Initially I am checking the join checks. Click on OK. So it will showing the warning messages. No warning message is found here like this. So again we have to click on the analyze option. So initially we need to select the load cases. Click on select here. So the pushover load case will be comes under your action of the dead load, live load and pushover load case only. So remaining load case we need to turn off. So click on do not run for the earthquake loading condition. Again wind load also do not run option here. So click on run now option. Now my model is analyzing for the pushover load cases. Okay. So it will take some time, depends upon your respective structure. Basically for the small buildings, it will take around 3 to 5 minutes for the G+1, G+2 structures. Depends upon your system specifications. So basically for high rise buildings or high rise structure, it will take around 12 hours or 20 hours or 24 hours. Depends upon your considerations of the load cases. So for this respected G+1 building, it was taken 3 minutes for analysis of this respective structure for me. So this is the pushover load case diagram under the action of the modal time period and 0.251 and mode 1. Click on this respected arrow. So now you can see this is the mode 2, this is the mode 3, this is the mode 4 diagram, this is the mode 5 diagram, mode 6 diagram. So this is the 7th one, this is the 8th one, this is the 9th one, this is the 10th one, this is the 11th, this is the 12th one, this is the first one. Okay. So this is the diagram which is showing for the respected pushover load case under the different types of the hinge properties. So to show that respected values, we have to click on the display option here. So click on deform shape, which is related to the pushover load case. So click on apply here, click on OK. So after that, it will show you respected hinge properties numbers here like this, which is consisting of the green mark. So select the next node point. Now you can see hinge properties will be modeled here like this. And this is the hinge properties for the mode 2. And this is for mode 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So click on 11th, 12th option. So 13th one, 14th one, 15th one, 16th one, and this is the 17th one, and this is the last one, and this is the scale which is related to the mode formation as per the pushover load considerations. So after checking the hinge results which is related to the mode formations, we need to check the pushover curves. So for that, go to click on display option here. So initially we need to click on static pushover curve here. Okay. So in this, it will show you a respected curve which is comes under the base shear versus monitor displacement value. Okay. So this is the base shear in y axis. This is the monitor displacement. So you can change the load case name from pushover x to pushover y condition. So it will change your respected graph here like this. Okay. So after that, we have to show the plot for this respected FEMEA 440 EL curve. Select this respected option. So now we can see this is the FEMEA CL curve, which is related to the spectral displacement value and spectral acceleration, which is comes under the pushover y condition, and select here as a pushover x condition. Now you can see this is a pushover x condition FEMEA 440 curve, which is comes under spectral displacement and spectral acceleration for this respected section. You can change the axis type from the spectral acceleration to the time period, and you can change the curve to the spectral displacement to the time period like this. So it will show your respected pushover curves here like this. Okay. So this is a complete process pushover analysis of G+1 building by using ETAP software. If you have any queries about this respected video, please text me your questions in the below comment box. I will try to give the answer for that respected questions. Thank you.